All right, we are pairing wine and chocolate this morning. We've got the two best people to do it. We've got Michael from Benmoral Vineyards Winery right there, and Oliver Keita, world-renowned chocolatier. Is that right?
Wait, that's all it. Right. You got it.
All right, so Oliver, explain to me some of the chocolates that you brought with you. These, first of all, they look beautiful.
This is shameless advertising. These are the Hudson Valley Natural Bars that are hand-cast and hand-wrapped. I'm in Rhinebeck, New York, one of the top 10 chocolatiers in North America. And I brought an almond bar with 70% dark organic chocolate, a beautiful, rich, creamy, dark 38% milk chocolate for you, our award-winning peanut butter bar that has organic peanut butter and dark chocolate in the middle. It is absolutely sensual and delightful. And then to finish it off, when we're done with the wine, we have one that's called Vandermint, which is named after the Vanderbilt Mansion, and it has an organic peppermint vanilla undertone to it with dark chocolate.
All right, so let's start with this one right here. This is the Annandale almond.
Yeah, so you want to start by breaking off a corner of the bar.
Now, Michael, what wine would I pair with this?
So I'm pairing my 2016 Cabernet Franc. It's one of our like staple varietals of Benmoral. It's got some nice like bright cherry, bright raspberry, very like dark velvety tannins to it. And it's very, it's got like a pepperiness, like a black pepper on the finish. So I think it'll be a pair perfect with this one.
All right, so here's my question. How do I do this?
All right, so Boris, No. You're going to, now I don't want to see any, I want to see some real excitement. So you put it in your mouth, and you chew it, and you move it around,
all right,
and you let it melt. Don't be prissy about this. Put it in your mouth and let it melt, and really let the flavor melt on your tongue. And as you breathe in, then you can start to taste the wine. And the two will come together for you, so you have a better, interesting flavor profile.
That is
what are you
not
sensing?
What I expected.
Uh-huh.
What did you say? I feel titillation.
Mm.
That's what I feel.
Excited?
Right. Excited.
Sense of well-being. Are you on the serotonin train yet? Are you feeling an uptake yet?
I did get a little rush.
Nothing like chocolate in the morning.
Yeah, perfect. But I would never think to pair with wine for some reason. And
it really
goes so well together.
It does. Starts you out really great in the morning, gets the day going, and anything else that you don't want to deal with after this, you just say, too bad. Chocolate and wine, maybe.
I like that. It's a very hearty kind of mixture there with the two of them together. Now, next we've got the very rich milk chocolate. So let's see what you're going to pair with that one here.
Now, that's going to be a little trickier for you to try because you're going to have a creamy, rich, malty flavor in there.
Okay.
So put that in your mouth first and chew it. And he's going to pair it with a rosé wine, and you're going to see...
Now, I do it rough, right?
Mm-hmm. Yeah. What we're looking for are three things to happen. Either you want the wine and chocolate contrast, or you want the wine and chocolate to highlight each other, or they don't fit at all.
So I'm getting that smoothie velvetiness and...
That's a good word for it, too.
And that kind of dries it out right there at the end of that. It's a little drier.
There's some acidity to it. I think it bounced back.
That's pretty good. Now, what is this again?
Oh, this is our dry rosé.
The dry rosé. Well, there you go.
This one right here?
Yep. It's really nice.
That is
fantastic.
A really
good
one of the best dry rosé.
It really changes the whole experience of eating chocolate.
I love
drinking wine. That, like, it creates like a whole new thing.
Put you in a really great mood.
Since you walked in the door, this is the one I wanted to try.
I know you did.
This is the one I wanted to try. So this is the peanut butter.
Let's just break it.
Peanut butter and crispy rice.
That's the one.
Ooh,
that one is kind of like crack, so be careful how much you eat.
It's a little soft in the middle.
Well, it's a traditional type of bar. Oh, wow. I'll have a little of that also, just to cheer him on.
Oh my goodness.
So it is a method where we actually pour the chocolate into the mold, dump most of it out, and then we make the filling, we hand fill it into the bar, so it's kind of a layered bar. Happy yet?
What is that?
Marlboro Village Red. Probably goes perfect with it, because it's very nice. It's really nice, like fruit forward, like... Sweet perception, but it's bone dry. It's different.
So I'm enjoying this.
Amazing.
I'm enjoying this chocolate immensely, and I'm enjoying this. And so as I'm eating it, I'm like, this can't get any better.
Yeah.
But I don't know what this does to it, but the two taste together.
Yeah, hand in hand.
Hold on.
I know, the only thing missing is the piece of bread.
You need like fireworks sound effects going off in the background. This is really good. This is incredible.
Happiness all around, everybody. I'll tell you that.
Yeah. This is going to be so much fun this weekend. We've got the big event happening this weekend. The Hudson. Come on over here and explain exactly what is this event?
It's the Hudson Valley Wine and Chocolate Festival. And it's May 5th and 6th at Paterson, New York. We have 85 vendors.
Mm.
Oliver is being highlighted, and so is Ben Marl. But we have crafts, and everything's honed in from the Hudson Valley, farm to table. So we do only local product, and it shows quality. And it is stimulating, and it is well worth coming.
Yeah, I'm having my own little tiny version of the festival here, And this is well worth it. This is so, so incredible. It really is.
Yeah.
Now, I want to end the way you said with the Vandermint.
The Vandermint, yes.
So this is
yes.
like an after we've had all the
right.
samples.
Right. I would think of it as après the vin, after the wine, a little bit.
Okay.
It's light, though. It's not like anything that has the H word in it or anything like that. So.
It's not like those after 8 minutes.
No. That's right. You said it, not me, Boris.
Oh,
it's
yeah.
just supposed to be light. Just more about the dark chocolate, and then the mint just comes through. It's organic.
And it, that tastes like actual mint and not like some sort of like mint
mouthwash
that somebody
exactly.
put in. This is really good.
Thank you.
Wow. Incredible stuff. Michael Benmarle Winery, Oliver Keita from Oliver Keita Chocolates. Check these guys out this weekend. It's going to be so much fun. We have more details up on our website at WPDH.com. I'm like shaking. This is so good. It really is. What a great experience. Thank you so much,
My
guys.
Treat.
I appreciate it. Thank you.